everybody, to Madison Square Garden. It's Big East Showdown time here. The first of two semifinals. Cinderella, if you will, the Pirates of Seton Hall against Syracuse. Seton Hall upset the Hoyas to get here yesterday. For the first time, this school will play in the semifinal of this tournament. Later today, it'll be Pittsburgh against Villanova. Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome. I'm Brent Musburger. Syracuse, if you will, has appeared more times on network television this fall than, well, Johnny Carson. As for Seton Hall, never in the school's history have they played live on one of the three major networks. But here they are this afternoon. Let's meet their star. He's 6'9", center Mark Bryant. He grew up in the shadow of this New Jersey school, about 10 minutes from the campus, which is located just outside Newark. He has averaged better than 20 points a game and pulled down almost 10 rebounds. Yet very few people know about Mark Bryant.
I'm definitely the Roger Dangerfield. I don't get no respect, but, you know, I just keep working hard for it, and eventually it will come to me.
But he is starting to earn that respect, and there is another marvelous story involving Seton Hall and Billy Packer. That is their bearded coach, one P.J. Carlissimo.
Brent, I have to go back a long way, and I think of the days when Dean Smith was hung in effigy. They said he couldn't get the job done at North Carolina. Well, for P.J., who's now under a new five-year contract, he was actually hung this year by the student body in his own campus. He has a legitimate shot at winning this championship and moving well into the NCAA tournament.
You know, it's interesting, after upsetting the Hoyas yesterday, that's exactly what Peter John Carlissimo told us.
On a given day, it doesn't matter where we're playing. I think if you go through our league and you play in the buildings we play in against the kind of teams we play with crowds and all that, you can play anywhere. We're not the best team in the country, but there's nobody that we can't play with.
A win here now, and you'll play for the Big East Championship tomorrow against the winner of Pitt Villanova. It's coming up live.
CBS Sports coverage of today's Big East Tournament semifinal game is sponsored by the U.S. Navy. We invite you to learn the technology of tomorrow and the Navy of today. Your local 7-Up bottler. And by Mazda, bringing performance and value together. That's the Mazda way.
You wouldn't believe how many families I've recommended the Mazda 626 to. They just love the giant interior. They all say the 626 drives like an expensive road car and can't believe all the car they get for the money. But I like the fact that the 626 not only comes as a traditional four-door sedan, which I bet you thought you were looking at. Surprise! You've been looking at the slick five-door touring sedan. My station wagon. In disguise.
Make red. Make blue. Be blue. Make colors as bright as life. Make colors feel like colors feel.
The brilliant colors of life. Trust RCA to bring them to you on Precision Performance Big Screen TV. Only from RCA, the most trusted name in electronics. From the Industrial Tool Division of Black & Decker. Tough ball and roller bearings, two speed ranges, and a powerful 5 amps that can deliver over 49,000 beats per minute. Ask a man who's used one lately. Nothing beats a Black & Decker.
Dentists warn, the number one dental problem isn't cavities. It isn't tartar. It's plaque. Building up on your teeth every day. And no matter how much you brush, you don't get enough plaque off your teeth, especially in hard-to-reach places. The problem is plaque. The solution is Plaques. Rinse with Plaques before brushing, and you'll remove 300% more plaque than brushing alone. Plaques. Original flavor and now new soft mint. Removes 300% more plaque than brushing alone.
Carlissimo, in his sixth year as the head coach of Seton Hall, he will start this lineup. Now the big fella is Brian. I told you he is a senior. Sally, too, is a senior. And Ramos,
He's the center from Puerto Rico, a junior. In the backcourt, they'll go with a junior in Morton, and also Green, who is only a junior. Jim Boeheim, of course, you're extremely familiar with what he did, taking the Orange men to the title last year. Coleman, a sophomore. Thompson, only a sophomore. Cycley's a senior. Douglas is a junior, and Rowe, next to him, is a sophomore. So those are the starting lineups here this afternoon. And as this game begins to unfold, we will bring you up to date on these players from Seton Hall. For example, the young man jumping center right now, Ramon Ramos. Pats it a second time, but it winds up in the hands of Sherman Douglas. So Syracuse with possession off the opening tap. Their quarterback, he's a splendid floor leader and an underrated defensive player. It's hard to say that Sherman Douglas is underrated, but he ranks with the best point guards in all the land. Puts a move on, and he was fouled, drawing the first foul, and he was hit there on the lip.
Brent, one of the things you see right off the top, Seton Hall playing tough man-to-man defense, and basically it's each man taking an opponent and sticking with him. Not a lot of weak side help there, so there was a great clear out for Douglas to be able to go one and one.
First foul on Morton. Our referee is Jim Burr. He is working with Jackie Hannon and Jim Howell here this afternoon. Howell there with his back to you. Cycling.
Same situation. You see, Ramos has no help whatsoever on Cycling, so if they're going to play that way, you can expect Syracuse to go inside early and often. 2-3 zone by Syracuse.
Bob to Ramos, extremely strong. He'll come to the line, a chance to put Seton Hall ahead. And talking to Cycley and Coleman a few moments before this game started, Cycley said Ramos is stronger than Bryant. Now, he was a member of the Puerto Rican national team and hopes to be a member and qualify for the Korean Olympics. And Coach Carlissimo, who goes down to Puerto Rico to coach in the summertime, scouted him at a young age down there. His three-point play puts the Pirates up here. Long pass, Douglas. Thompson's there, and he is fouled. That's two fouls now on Seton Hall, this one on Sally.
Going against that full court pressure, Thompson, who has had a tremendous ball game, his best game of the year, actually, against Seton Hall, because the matchup is pretty good for him on Sally. Good long pass, and there he is, Stevie Thompson, with that ability to score inside.
Not a good free throw shooter.
That, Brent, about this ball club. And you just have to feel, as stats have proven, that in close ball games, this is their Achilles heel.
You know, I was thinking it yesterday, Billy, and then Ronnie Cycley went and hit 10 in a row, and here Thompson misses their first two. Simply a matter of concentration at the free throw line, and Syracuse still struggling with it. This is Bryant trying to get off early. Ramos can't keep it alive, and Coleman yanks it out, and the quarterback, Douglas, with the pass to Thompson. Great ball movement, but Cycley couldn't get a hand on it.
Well, you can see what this is doing for Syracuse, though, getting it in the running-type ball game they want. Cycley showed great speed coming out from that zone.
This is Bryant, great jump shot artist, off to the right that time. Cycley can't control it. This is Sally, and Green will slow it down and call the play, and Syracuse retreats into that 2-3 zone. From the Southeastern Conference, LSU playing at home, trying to tie down a bid to the NCAA. Certainly a victory today would get them a spot on the field of 64, you would have to think.
How would you like to have been in that Dale Brown locker room for that one? He said they are going to win the SEC championship.
Morton bangs one in, and I want to tell you, Carlissimo says this Seton Hall team can play with anybody in the Big East. Purdue, meanwhile, trying to come off that tough loss to Ohio State and fine-tune things for the NCAA. They'll be a number one seed tomorrow, no question about it. We're not sure where they'll go. We'll find out at 5:30.
You see Ramos again with Cycli all by himself, no help. It'll be hard for him to handle it.
Loose. Coleman tracks it down. Now Rowe wants the three. And out comes Green on the move. The Pirates pound it down at him. Green goes inside to the big three.
This has been the big change in this Seton Hall ball club since they've got on this run of great win streak, is Green going into that starting lineup.
Now a little shake and bake from Douglas, has to toss it up. Cycley goes after it, out of bounds, Syracuse ball.
There you're going to see a great move by Green as he really goes by Sherman Douglas, then uses the left hand, protects it with the body.
Cycley dives for the ball. They'll be tied up with it, and the possession arrow sends it over to Seton Hall as Syracuse controlled the opening tap.
And Brent, this is the the way Seton Hall wants to play, but having watched Syracuse as we have, they really like this up-tempo type ball game. So it kind of plays into their hands a little bit.
Seton Hall off to a 3-of-5 start from the floor. Syracuse only 1-of-4. 17-10 to go here in the first half. Dropping into the big fella, and Bryant hits Morton Cutting. Nice pass.
Morton's got great size inside. He has had a problem at the point guard position, but now with Green in the lineup, he can move back and be a guy that's a scorer rather than a man that's the assist man.
Coleman double-teamed by Morton, who breaks free now at the offensive end. He'll try to save it.
Oh, better hustle.
And Seton Hall out-hustling Syracuse here early. They're going for the loose balls. They're playing with more intensity right now.
Syracuse staying in their 2-3 zone.
Bryant not looking for the shot. He wanted to give it back on the drive, and a beautiful move by Sally.
Jimmy Boeheim going for the timeout. Very upset.
Well, St. John's is out, and so the city now falling behind the Pirates of Seton Hall.
Our future, we invite you to learn the technology of tomorrow while you serve your country in the Navy of today.
Are you up to the challenge? The 7-Up College Basketball Championship Challenge. You could win up to $10,000. Just twist the specially marked caps off bottles of any 7-Up brand. Match the winner's score in the April 4th championship game and you win. Just claim your prize to Western Union. There's over 1 million potential winners. So start saving those caps now, because until the final buzzer, it's anybody's ball game.
At least once in your life, you owe yourself a car like this.
You gotta go where you wanna go, and do what you wanna go, and do it in whoever you wanna go. You gotta go where you wanna go, and do what you wanna go, and do it in whoever you wanna go. You gotta go where you wanna do what you want.
Syracuse zone. Now this is the weak side of the court over here. Watch how nobody drops back to help as Coleman goes over, leaving the middle wide open on this particular play by Seton Hall. Nobody fills the spot. Cycli too late getting over there. Should have been waiting on that pass.
Well, Mother Seton would be awfully proud of how her namesake has exploded here early this afternoon in this semifinal of the Big East. They go to full court pressure now and pick the ball up as Brower is the first sub off Boeheim's bench. Cycli sits right now.
That might have been the first time all year Rowe has brought the ball up the court by himself, because Morton doing a great job that time on Douglas.
They make Douglas work hard here at the offensive end. Now Coleman with that turnaround jump shot, misfiring, but open on the other side was Thompson for the easy tap back.
Thompson likes Sally a lot better than he likes to play against Jerome Lane, that's for sure.
Giving Cycli a look at what Seton Hall is trying to do down inside right now from the bench. Sally forced to come back out by Thompson.
And Syracuse goes man-to-man with Brower playing on Ramos. Coleman down on Bryant.
Ramos brings him back to the outside here on the left wing. Now he starts to back in, and Morton comes up with a jump shot. Coleman had a hand, and he was fouled from behind. That's the first foul on Bryant. As far as the team fouls are concerned, that's 3 on Seton Hall and 2 on Syracuse.
Seton Hall pulls their press off.
When you look at Sherman Douglas, Billy, you have to think he's a Hoya disguised as an orange. He can play with that intensity. Georgetown almost scratched back yesterday with great full court pressure, but Seton Hall was equal to that challenge. They did not wilt as some thought they might.
No spacing in there whatsoever for Thompson to force that ball inside.
This team is playing with some poise early. Carlissimo's done a good job with this team. Now Ramos with his man. Coleman comes over to help out, and Bryant's got the loose ball, stolen by Douglas in a foot race. Brower gives it back.
credit Derek Brower with that play right there. Giving the ball back. He could have put his head down and tried to go to the hoop. Would have been able to be defended. It's got to go to Bryant now and make Coleman work a little bit.
Coleman half fronting him, working with his arm down on the inside. You can watch away from the ball now because Bryant's the man. They'll try to get into that jump shooting rhythm. Bernard King's his hero. He'll remind some of you of King a little bit with his jump shot.
Syracuse playing some tough man-to-man. Good help out by Brower.
Ramos up. There's Bryant.
Back. You can't fault Coleman on that one. He came over to help out.
Douglas slips. Rowe tracks it down. Here's Brower open and high. And traveled.
That's not his play, and of course, Cycli's going to come in and take his place on that one.
Running second on the four.
Along with Billy Packer, I'm Brent Musburger. Welcome to Madison Square Garden and the first of two Big East semifinals here this afternoon. This is Syracuse against Seton Hall. And the Pirates explode for an early 13-6 lead at the 13:56 mark. Seton Hall will send in Daryl Walker as their first sub, number 24. And Duncan now in for Syracuse, number 14.
With
and Morton
back in
gets inside. Billy, what's your feeling about this Seton Hall defense against Syracuse?
Well, I think they've taken the game so far to Syracuse with their aggressiveness. Now, Walker having a problem there with Coleman going right over the top. I'm sure PJ just wants to give Ramos a little rest. But they'll have some problems with this matchup of Walker and Bryant playing against Cycli and Coleman.
And Green's foul, his first, puts Coleman up on the line.
Derek Coleman, shooting two.
Now they missed their first three.
You know, the thing about Syracuse, too, they go to the line so much, Brent. Shooting down in the 60 percentile. If they were ever up at the 75% or 72% as a team, they would be. Their record would be improved immensely.
Sally, short. Oh, going hard is Walker for his first field goal.
You get the feeling Seton Hall wants this game more than Syracuse at this point. I don't think there's any question about it.
They are playing with great intensity. They've been beaten twice this year by Syracuse. Duncan open. Coleman rebounding. And Cycli winds up with the loose ball and then makes a bad pass out of bounds as Douglas cut to the inside. A sloppy start by Syracuse.
And Ronnie Cycli had a very poor game for him yesterday. And that was just a pass that he had an easy play to make to Duncan. Bryant and Coleman, they're really putting the arms on each other.
Walker again, and Cycli fouled him. He'll shoot a pair. Billy, you wonder if Seton Hall can keep it up at this level.
Oh, I think that they can. You know, this is not a fluke. This is a ball club that took Pitt two ball games. The game that they beat Pitt over at in Pittsburgh, and I watched that. This was a ball club that had a nice lead. Pitt came back and took it over, and they did not wilt. They came right back in and won the ball game.
Now, they opened up a big lead on John Thompson yesterday, and it was that Hoya press that brought them back and gave them a chance to tie the game and get into overtime. Syracuse does not play that kind of a full-court press defense.
I would agree, and the case here is that their front lines match up well. And remember last year, this Seton Hall club that had problems in the backcourt, they beat Georgetown, the number one seed, twice.
Seton Hall going to the trap that time. Ball deflected out of bounds, Orangeman.
PJ put it pretty well, the opening of the show. We might not be the best team in the country, but we feel we can beat anybody on a given day.
I'll tell you, that Purdue team can beat anybody on a given day, too. Walker taking Cycli on the inside. They're not giving Syracuse any easy shots. They've had a hand in their face all game long. Four team fouls on Seton Hall.
Notice that the inside power here, Coleman and Bryant on both ends of the floor, they're using those forearms very well. Bryant getting in front of Coleman. Look at how everything's packed back in there. Nobody out on the perimeter to create some passing lanes.
So Douglas goes in on the drive, missing. Seton Hall comes out on the run.
Oh, what a pass. He had the right idea.
How about that Maryland team? They upset Georgia Tech. Now they lead by a point as we continue to track this final weekend of the regular season.
I don't know where to start telling you about Mazda trucks. They've been rated first in customer satisfaction 2 years in a row. They got the best warranty in the truck business. It covers you bumper to bumper. This 40 new SE5 comes with everything you're looking at. And it's still priced like Toyota and Nissan's base trucks. So I don't know where you start. I guess it doesn't make any difference. You wind up here.
This is the Mazda way.
Hey, sounded good. Save a few bucks, get the same quality. Then the gripes start from data processing. I got garbage all over the orders. Pittsburgh now takes all night to download delivery schedules.
AT&T gives you the fastest, most error-free data transmission.
I'm paying 32 truckers to drink coffee. This is a good deal?
AT&T's Worldwide Intelligent Network. Because we know it's not just long distance. It's your business on the line. AT&T, the right choice.
Ever since your post office invented express mail overnight delivery, others have tried to copy our eagle. But it's not so easy. Because express mail has overnight reliability that's close to perfect, the most convenient locations, and prices as low as $10.75. Most others charge you about twice that. So if you want a combination of low prices, convenience, and reliability no one can imitate, use the original express mail service from your post office.
Iowa, Indiana. A battle in the Big Ten as the Hawkeyes face off against Bobby Knight's Hoosiers. Next on the home of the NCAA championship.
Big East semifinal. Billy Packer, who are some of the more famous basketball graduates to have played at Seton Hall?
Davis and Wanzer, two of the greatest backcourt players of all time. Walter Dukes was a great one. Richie Regan was a great one. But you got two Hall of Famers there in Wanzer and Davis.
Oh, they must be proud of how their alma mater is doing here this afternoon. Billy, in one word, how would you describe the game and why Seton Hall is ahead?
I'd say hustle. They've come to win this ball game, and I think Syracuse has come to rest on their laurels a little bit so far anyway.
There's an awful lot of talent on this Syracuse team. They'll make at least one run and perhaps two before this baby's over.
Back to the 2-3 zone. They've really packed it back inside. There's going to be a perimeter shot available. And their best outside shooter, Major, who was a leading scorer last year, is on the bench. There's the outside shot.
Green's three over everything, and Coleman couldn't hold on, but Douglas runs it down on the loose ball. And hit by two defenders, goes cross.
Great.
And Douglas touches Coleman.
Sherman Douglas is, without question, one of the best guards in the country. And there was a Larry Bird type play where you actually make the pass before you catch the ball. Now watch Sherman. He knew exactly what he was going to do with it as the ball was coming cross court. And that's what made the play.
Fifth missed free throw by Syracuse here this afternoon. 19-8, 11 minutes to go. Sally maneuvering, and now it's Walker's jump shot short. And Douglas again comes up with a loose ball. A three. Coleman inside.
Number 4, Coleman. Our 3, 19-10.
Bryant will play face up, and he lost the handle, but it went right to Sally, who couldn't get the jam to stay down. This could start to trigger a Syracuse run. They love the lob, but Thompson was covered. Now it's Duncan. It won't stay. And Seton Hall will bring it out.
I think Duncan expected more body against him when he went in there, and he was so wide open that he didn't concentrate. Now back to the man-to-man. Both teams trying to change up a little bit.
There's Sally, blocked by Coleman, cycling out into the hands of Douglas. Thompson's in the middle, 3-on-2, and Steven rotates, and it's batted out of bounds by Bryant. Ramos returns. Bryant takes his first break.
Brent, it's a very unusual thing. We've played 10 minutes right on the money. Syracuse only with 10 points in a game that actually has been run and chewed up and down the court. They're just not getting any offensive structure at all so far.
Walker leaning on Coleman. Ramos here on Cycli. Cycli wants it. He gets hit from the weak side with a double team. Goes up to the glass, uses his height advantage for the field goal. Now the Orangemen pulling back into it.
Five. They got the timeout, and they really got a break there because a great play by Sherman Douglas to pick up full court.
So we've got a timeout here in the Garden at the 9:36 mark. We'll be right back.
Of all the cars that come out each year, only one can be the Motor Trend Car of the Year. For 1988, that one is this one. The hot new Pontiac Grand Prix.
Get on your Pontiac and ride! Pontiac ride!
The new Grand Prix, Motor Trend's Car of the Year. You've got to drive it.
Get on your Pontiac!
Rebuilding Titan!
My grandfather was a carpenter. My dad's a carpenter. Yes, building things is in my blood.
The Sawcat, from the Industrial Tool Division of Black & Decker. Tough ball and roller bearings, cut steel helical gears for precision and power, job after job.
You know, you start in the morning, there's nothing. And at the end of the day, there's proof you've been there.
Ask a man who's used one lately. Nothing beats a Black & Decker.
It's like the right girl with the right man, or the right way with the right man. Take a new step, make your next round. The silver bullet, it won't slow you down. So come on in the cool light, it's the right beer now.
The good life, yeah.
The good life, yeah. So come on in the cool light, it's the right beer now.
Monday on Wise Guy.
Mel Prophet is dead.
With the crime czar gone, Vinny may be in deeper than ever.
I love you, Vinny. I can't wait to have our baby.
Wise Guy.
Billy, it seems like only yesterday that we were greeted by those preseason basketball polls. Syracuse, a unanimous number one. What's happened to the Orangemen this year?
Well, you know, Brent, they came off that great Final Four. They do have the nucleus of their ball club back, and I just think that they're waiting to go back to the Final Four, not realizing how hard you have to work to get there.
Yeah, you don't get a free ticket to Kansas City.
Exactly. Here comes a half-court trap.
Green gets it into Cooper's hands, who checked in for the first time. Cooper out of Atlanta. Well, look, it up to Green.
Now, that's a great play by Green. It didn't sound like much. It won't be on the statistics, but he pulled the ball back out, eliminated that half-court pressure instead of just trying to make the great play.
They trap Ramos in the corner. Morton gets it to the open man, who's Cooper, and Cycling with a strong defensive play tracks it down. Douglas comes back now to half-court.
Cycli second or third block. We saw Charlie Smith from Pittsburgh block seven last night. No perimeter game whatsoever for Syracuse so far, and that's really hurt them.
There's Morton off the dribble. He travels. Take a look at the Seton Hall bench there, folks. I tell you, this is the first team I've ever seen with more assistant coaches than the Alabama football team.
And not a priest among them. That's very unusual for a Catholic team up here in the East.
I think we have nine schools in the Big East, Billy, and six of them are Catholic.
They normally have a father or two over there with the rosaries.
Inside to Thompson with that nice delayed jump shot of his, kind of leaning back with the left hand. Cross, they want Cooper. Through the foul on Cycling. That's his second. And the team's third.
Jimmy Boeheim has already ripped Cycli twice, okay? So I figure that with 12 minutes gone in the first half, he can't afford the third rip in the first half, but that's why he didn't get on in there, because Cycli should have been back on defense.
Not yet over the limit, so they're not shooting, and he was not in the act of shooting, so they send out a bad pass. pass, and Douglas in a foot race against
Morton.
Coming
back with it. I thought he dumped it back to Coleman on the... He didn't have to.
He's fouled by Duncan. That's a foolish foul back here in the backcourt. A little bit later, we're going to send you back out to the Big Ten. Billy, I don't have much doubt about Bob Knight, but I heard James Brown and Jim Nance mentioning that that team could be on the fence. Is that possible?
You know, I find it very difficult with the record that they've had in the Big Ten this year. They're going to take multiple teams. Almost every game in that conference has been a war. I would find it hard to believe they wouldn't be in.
Yeah, that's James Major, number 10, who just checked in, missing the shot. And there was a foul against Seton Hall. Now, Syracuse is on a 10-0 run here in the last 5 minutes, so things have not gone well. And I'll tell you when it turned. When Sally missed the jam down here and it came out the other end. That's three fouls on the big fella, too.
Boy, that really hurts. Bryant going out early. Talking about a guy that has had some monster games of late. Averaging in the mid-20s against outstanding competition.
It's going to be real tough for Seton Hall to hold on without the big fella.
Interesting to see what Major does in the ballgame now. Has the opportunity to have a hot hand. He was the leading scorer last year.
Cycli being leaned on and comes inside with that scoop shot. He scored six here, and they're back to within one. They were down by 14, so here's their first run.
Good double team. They're really giving Seton Hall trouble.
Cooper and Cycli didn't want to take his third, so he let him have the layup. A wise move. It's 21-18, and we've still got 7.5 minutes to go in the first half.
Ronnie Cycli really should have prevented that pass from going across there, though, Brent, because they had a Major in real trouble with the double team. Thompson wants to score against this bunch. He likes the matchup, doesn't he?
He sure does. He feels it, huh? Down away, got a three-second violation on Coleman.
Now, what Coleman's upset about, and rightfully so, he fought for position but didn't receive the pass. They're just so long that a man in the low post can hold his defender off. Upset about. He wants to touch that ball a little bit on something other than a rebound. Ramos, of course, not the same as Bryant in the middle, not looking for a shot.
Well, they're taking some time off with Bryant on the bench right now, too. Major maneuvers and Douglas with a great block from behind. And here he comes again. Three on one. Coleman!
He walked.
No basket. He traveled.
Derek was so anxious to score, he took a stroll, and he's smiling. Syracuse starting to get that break going, though, Brent, either off the defensive board or with the steal. Here they go out for the trap again. Trapping out of a 2-3 zone.
Walker off the fake.
That's really failing on that defense not to protect that pass going down under the basket. That's two in a row for Seton Hall. Ball to his big guy inside.
Cycli's turnaround missing. Major rebounds.
Oh, what a hot
Douglas
ball.
Gets it free. But Major tracks it down. What a great player Sherman Douglas is.
Major really sloppy with the ball right now, isn't he? Primarily a scorer. Very seldom do you see a guy who leads a team in scoring as a junior coming back as a senior and being relegated to the bench because they just couldn't get that backcourt working smoothly.
Cooper missing a left-handed shot, and Douglas down again and into the hands of Rowe. Douglas moving inside off the penetration shot. Back to within three, the Orange men come.
There's that patented running one-hander of his.
Some seconds is Bryant again sitting with three personal fouls. Ramos.
Well, Cycli can't very well be getting in a pushing match with Ramos inside. It might be smart to move Coleman over on him. They won't pick up any more foul trouble.
Douglas goes in and comes out. Now it's Coleman. Had it knocked away and he was fouled.
Walker has to understand Coleman's a left-hander. He's kind of on the side now. He was a right-hander.
Brower checked in, and you know there's a substitute for Seton Hall that you almost don't pick up. He's only 5'4". He's already out there. That was Nick Kosikas taking off his jersey. He'll play for the first time. 5'4". There he is, Pookie Wigginton. It'll remind you all the world of one Tyrone Bowes.
You know, he was a football player in the West Coast in addition to the great basketball career he had out there. And Brittany used to be a 6'4" middle linebacker.
Look at him box out Coleman that time.
6'4". The guys hit him on that pile drive, and now he's 5'4", playing in the backcourt. He gets it done, though.
Ramos' jump hook. He's 2-for-2 on that little turnaround down in the hole, and it's been important for the Pirates. They're up by 7 here at the 4:20 mark.
Bronze medal winner. See, they've gone to the zone now for the first time. 1-2-2. They do a lot of matching up out of this zone.
Might try to post up. See, we can see what they can do. Rose three, Shorten. Wigginton down with a rebound. Oh, he'll ignite this crowd if he can do anything here.
Ramos showing good patience. Very experienced ball player with all the international plays. As you know, bronze medal winner in the Pan Am Games last year. Like Seton Hall has had, six fellas play international ball of some type this past year.
Has a sister back home in California, and her name is Nuki. Katsikas under pressure, fired up one with time running out. Duncan to Thompson. Hello.
Stevie Thompson showed that explosive leaping ability is what prevented Katsikas from getting his jumper off and then just broke free. He loves playing against Seton Hall.
Katsikas traveled. We've got a television timeout here in the Garden. It's a 5-point game, Big East semifinals.
Debbie versus Katarina, the World Figure Skating Championships in 2 weeks.
Are you up to the challenge? The 7-Up College Basketball Championship Challenge. You could win up to $10,000. Just twist the specially marked caps off bottles of any 7-Up brand. Match the winner's score in the April 4th championship game and you win. Just claim your prize to Western Union. There's over 1 million potential winners. So start saving those caps now, because until the final buzzer, it's anybody's ball game. Feels so good, 7-Up.
The S-Class, the engineering flagships of Mercedes-Benz. And something more. Automobiles that evoke memories of a day long past. And a car so exotic that it turned a young boy's head. A heritage of legendary automobiles that have inspired dreams. The Mercedes-Benz S-Class. Nothing less than the best of every big Mercedes there ever was.
What kind of man uses Skin Bracer aftershave? A man who knows the difference between footwork and road work. Between a snow job and a job well done. Between something that merely makes you smell good and something that makes your skin look and feel good. Skin Bracer. Cool, soothes, tightens pores. You feel it taking care of your skin.
Thanks. I needed that.
When just smelling good isn't good enough, Skin Bracer aftershave.
Bye, Maymen.
On our way back to the Garden, I'm James Brown in Studio 43. At halftime on the College Basketball Report, Leslie Visser will join us with a special report on a negative phenomenon that threatens to mar the college game. And of course, Jim Nance and I will have scores and highlights. Now let's send you back to Brent and Billy.
All right, James, thank you. And here at the Garden, Seton Hall leading Syracuse 27-22. PJ Carlissimo's parents, Billy.
Yeah, and there's the father, not only of the coach and mother of the coach, but he's also the father of the NIT. Will be retiring from that position this year. One of the great men in collegiate athletics.
10 children. PJ is still a bachelor. Coach of the year in the Big East. The
Mom
most eligible bachelor, do you think?
Mom must be a good cook. He must go home often. I'd tell him to get himself a wife. If I had 10 kids, I don't want him hanging around.
Oh, cross-court pass by Herman Harid, who had just checked into the game.
That went up in the third row.
Walker, Wigginton, Ramos, Sally, and Morton on the floor for Seton Hall. Against Rowe, Brower, Thompson, now Harid, dunking along with Thompson, who I mentioned. Ramos is the offense.
Oh, nice move. That's his third big basket in this run to keep Seton Hall in the ballgame.
And a foul by Herman Harid.
Brower just not able to go up in the air like Coleman. Good idea to get it inside on that lob. Everybody tries to help, but Ramos is so strong inside and stays with it. See, Brower gets a little push off. Harid tries to help, but just not tough enough inside to stop it. In the case of Coleman and Cycli being out of there, that takes away that great shot blocking ability Syracuse has inside.
Sort of surprised that Boeheim didn't take a look at Harid last Sunday against Pittsburgh. Right, here he is this afternoon playing against Seton Hall.
Well, he's got a lineup that we haven't seen in a long time playing this early in the ballgame. Jimmy may be playing his first half to get to the second, realizing you got to play 3 days here if you're going to win a championship.
Utilizing a little more depth, if you will.
Oh, Harid's doing some crazy things, though, Brent.
That's a shot like someone who hasn't played. Maybe I'm getting my answer right here. Walker and Thompson got a hand on it, hit the referee, but Brower's got the loose ball.
Stevie Thompson's having a great first half.
Duncan's move, and here comes Thompson down the baseline.
Oh, what a shot!
That was Stephen Thompson. That was 29-24.
What you want to do is put him in a trance and tell him every team he plays is Seton Hall. Straight man to man, and Seton Hall a little mystified here, not getting in their offense. Chris Bryant's been on the bench, Brent, for what, about 6-7 minutes here.
Time running out, and Harid can't get the handle. A fresh 45 in the ball for Seton Hall.
Well, you've heard about a guy being a human highlight film. Harid is almost that in his 2 minutes he's played.
You know, it's really tough for a youngster like Harid. He gets a chance he wants so hard to impress the coaching staff so he can get a few more minutes, and then one bad thing after another occurs out here on the floor, and Pookie open will take the jump shot.
Had a big game this year against the University of Florida in the NIT, where Seton Hall battled their way back against Norm Sloan's club that was playing very well at that time of year.
Even without Bryant, Carlissimo's Pirates are maintaining their lead. It's a 7 points coming down toward the end of the first half here in the Garden.
You see Syracuse not holding for the last shot, and I think that they should. Like they're running their offense, trying to get something early, because you don't want Seton Hall to get two more up there before this half is out. Good defense.
Row off the fake.
They ought to pull it back out and look for one, Brent.
Row to Cycli, and he is fouled. There was no time left on the shot clock.
Well, when he put that shot up, of course, that took that situation off, so that still have 7 seconds left. Seton Hall has plenty of time to go down for one.
This is the first of two semifinals here in Chapman in the Garden. Last night, Pittsburgh came back against Connecticut for a win, and Villanova eliminated St. John's, and the Redmen still have to be scratching their heads. They had that one under control and let it get away from them. Could knock them out of the field of 64, too. St. John's struggling down the stretch.
0-7. Brent, in that game yesterday, I thought Shelton Jones had a sensational performance for St. John's, and all they had to do is just protect the ball the rest of the way, the 6-point lead. Good job by Villanova kids coming back.
So they're 0-8 at the free throw line here in the first half. Seton Hall will will take a lead as we hit the intermission. The end of the first half with the score, Seton Hall 31, Syracuse 24. Jim Nansen, James Brown return now with a college basketball report after this message and a word from your local stations.
CBS Sports coverage of today's Big East Tournament semifinal game is sponsored by Mercedes-Benz, engineered like no other car in the world.
The most punishing road in Europe is not the Appian Way in Italy. You will not find it in a remote section of the Tyrolean Alps. Or even some medieval village. Mercedes-Benz engineers would say they've built it here, in Sindelfingen, West Germany. A test of strength more brutal than any road. Punishing the car for weeks on end. Because in their quest for durability, Mercedes-Benz engineers just don't know when to stop.
Every day, over 30 million AT&T calls go through on the first try. Thanks to a remarkably intelligent network that forecasts traffic, anticipates tie-ups, and determines the quickest way around them. All in less time than it takes to dial. The AT&T network, you can call it the mastermind of long distance.
Glad I got through.
We're reaching further to bring your world closer. AT&T, the right choice.
Atlanta's Air Force, the Hawks, are hungry to topple the mighty Celtics. A feast in the East tomorrow.
This is CBS.
You know, any bank will give you a loan to improve your home, but more time to pay it back? You can't do that.
Oh, yes, you can.
My wife wants to buy a car, but the rates are too high. We can't afford a loan.
Oh, yes, you can.
Come to Central Trust. We'll work hard to help you qualify for a low interest rate money sale loan.
Maybe a new room and a car.
At Central Trust, oh, yes, you can.
To those of you who've been postponing your dreams of owning a BMW, your BMW dealer brings a ray of sunshine. A congenial financing program. So you no longer have to put your dreams on hold. 6.9 APR financing available for a limited time. See your participating BMW dealer for details.
Jim Nansen, welcome back to New York, where you see at halftime Seton Hall is beating Syracuse 31-24. Pretty impressive for the Pirates when you consider they've never been to the Big East semis before. All right, let's get caught up on the scores at the ACC tournament semifinal game. North Carolina leading Maryland. That's at halftime. J.R. Reed has 10 for the Tar Heels there. In the Big Eight semifinal game, Missouri and Oklahoma. That is in the first half, and the Sooners leading the Tigers by 9 there. Metro Conference semifinals, this just went to halftime, and Louisville is leading by 11 over South Carolina. In the SEC, 10 minutes to go, LSU and Kentucky in a wild one, and the Wildcats have come from behind now to take the lead there in Baton Rouge. Now, the 16th qualifier for the tournament came earlier today. That was Boston University winning the ECAC North Atlantic Tournament over Niagara, 79-68. And the Terriers went on a first-half tear. Three-point shot there by Tony DaCosta. He nails it. He had a career-high 26. As Coach Mike Jarvis, the high school coach of Patrick Ewing, takes the Terriers to the tournament for the first time in 5 years. Boston University winning there over Niagara. Now, Purdue and Minnesota, the Boilermakers already in the tournament. Talk about a good team. Here's why. All five starters in double figures today. Purdue easily over Minnesota. A reminder, coming up later today, you'll see Big Ten action. Iowa against Indiana. That'll get started at 4 o'clock Eastern time here on CBS. Coming up next, James Brown and Leslie Visser will talk about the battle in Big East as we continue on the road to the Final Four in just a moment.
Saying goodbye to a car you've owned for years is a lot like saying goodbye to an old friend. But if it's a Mercedes-Benz, there's always this cheering fact to consider. Over the years, Mercedes-Benz automobiles as a line have retained a higher percentage of their original value than any other make of car sold in America. And that can make the sorrow of parting a little sweeter.
At Pizza Hut, we make it fast.
We have time for lunch.
We make it hot.
It's gonna be hot, right?
And we make it great.
Great.
Making it fast. Making it hot. Keeping it everything we've got. Making your style. Give me a smile. Slicing and bicing. Cheese and pleasing.
At Pizza Hut, we go all out to make it fast, hot, and delicious.
Making it happen. Making your day. Pizza Hut. Making it great.
Honey, game's gonna start soon.
I think I'll give the lawn a quick cut.
Good luck.
When you're long on grass and short on time, you need a mower with a Briggs & Stratton engine.
Yeah, the pre-game show's on!
It'll start quickly and work hard till the job's done.
Sure hope he makes it.
Yes, there he is.
Briggs & Stratton, the power in power equipment.
Are you up to the challenge? The 7-Up College Basketball Championship Challenge. You could win up to $10,000. Just twist the specially marked caps off bottles of any 7-Up brand. Match the winner's score in the April 4th championship game and you win. Just claim your prize through Western Union. There's over 1 million potential winners. So start saving those caps now, because until the final buzzer, it's anybody's ballgame.
Nine of our student-athletes competed in the Olympics. Six of our eight baseball teams have qualified for postseason play. We've had over 100 All-Americans in men's and women's track and field. We had the NCAA soccer champion in 1981. We sent a women's basketball team to the NCAAs the past 4 years. We're the Big East Conference, a lot more than just men's basketball.
Two showdowns in the East. Atlanta's Air Force, the Hawks, tried to topple the mighty Celtics. And the Big East Tournament crowns its champion, the Beasts of the East, tomorrow.
Welcome back to the College Basketball Report on CBS. Earlier this week, NCAA Executive Director Dick Schultz announced that any player who throws a punch during a tournament game may face ejection from the rest of the tournament. This comes in response to an alarming trend toward violence in college basketball. And as our Leslie Visser reports, who also covers basketball for the Boston Globe, nowhere has this trend been more noticeable than in the Big East.
For the teams in the Big East, the road to the Final Four starts here at the Big East Tournament at Madison Square Garden. Considering some recent events, though, some people think it might be more appropriate to hold it around the corner at the Felt Forum, New York's boxing arena.
Ooh!
If you're going to teach your kids to come at you for 40 minutes, the other kid's going to get a little bit angry, and that kind of happens.
The coaches and players go at it as hard as you can go. I don't think anybody thinks that we have any more of a problem than any place else has.
Here we go. Lane, and here comes the Pittsburgh bench.
When you're 10, 11 years old, don't you always fight with your brother or sister? And now we're under the boards right now. Think about it. We have all these bodies in the baskets under the boards right now, getting tangled up. It's all part of the game.
But with four major outbursts in the Big East this season, others might disagree.
There are times where the intensity tends to go overboard. I think the Big East has kind of spun off its axis in the last couple months, and it really needs to get its rotation back.
It's ridiculous. I mean, there's no excuse for fighting, and there's no place for it. It's not what the game's all about. Part of sports is to be have enough self-discipline when somebody whacks you, is not to retaliate.
I think perception's in the eyes of the beholder. So it's in whoever's looking at the Big East. I think our own perception is that we're a very competitive league at the very highest level, and we're pleased with that.
3 weeks ago, when Pittsburgh and Georgetown fought for the second time this season, Gavitt and the Big East Executive Committee reacted. The result? A five-point policy was adopted. In essence, the rules suspend any player ejected for fighting for one conference game. And, with the exception of the head coach, anyone leaving the bench faces the same penalty.
You don't have to be a clairvoyant to know that the growth of college basketball has had some sidelights to it across the country that are less than desirable. I think that everyone involved in college basketball, administrators, coaches, players, fans, alumni, students, need to rules makers need to reassess a little bit where they're coming from.
I think the rule is a good one. But when emotion is involved, I think it's very difficult to control that.
Karnaseca should know. His Redmen fought with Providence just 10 days after the new rules were enacted. This one spread to the stands, and Jason Williams of St. John's became the first victim of the new rules. In addition, a fan filed an assault charge against Williams.
I think Eastern basketball tends to be aggressive and intense just by its very nature. And I think because you've got a glamour conference where you've got a rising balance of power, you're in a situation suddenly where everyone wants a piece of the gold at the end of the rainbow.
It's something that, because of the area, because of the intensity of the game, because of the rules, that sometimes people get excited.
Gordy Chiesa mentioned the congestion of bodies under the basket as a factor contributing to the fighting. Well, the Sun Belt Conference has a suggestion for alleviating this problem, and that is to widen the lane from 12 to 16 feet. That might give the players more breathing room.
Leslie, in addition to widening the lane, what other reasons have led to the increased violence?
Well, James, I think there's a fine line between aggressiveness and belligerence, and teams have to be careful not to cross it.
Well, all right, Leslie, thank you very much. Jim?
All right. James, Leslie, thank you very much. Again, a very wild game going on in Baton Rouge. That's the SEC tournament semifinals. 5 minutes to go in that contest, and LSU now has just hit a three-point bucket to move in front of Kentucky, 76-75. The Tigers might need to win this game to get into the tournament because Dale Brown's team has 12 losses. The winner of this game will take on the winner of the Georgia-Florida semifinal showdown that's coming up later this afternoon in Baton Rouge. We'll see you back here after the game. Right now, we're getting set for the second half. Seton Hall leading Syracuse, 31-24. Bench scoring, by the way, 10-0. The Pirates have outscored the Orangemen bench, and Syracuse 0-for-8 from the line as the Seton Hall team leading at 31-24 over at the Madison Square Garden. All right, Brent and Billy getting set for the second half. We'll take you back there after this message and a word from your local station.
Drive. This is what your next car should be. This is the all-new Pontiac Grand Prix.
Get on your Pontiac and ride! Pontiac ride!
This is the 1988 Motor Trend Car of the Year. And that ought to be you driving.
Get on your Pontiac! Rebuild excitement!
How to shave a giant.
Avoid big trouble. Use the Gillette Good News Plus disposable. It's got the Lubra Smooth Strip, so the comfortable shave for a giant is
this little guy.
Good News Plus from Gillette.
These are the hands of Mr. Goodwrench. Hands with the know-how to fix things. Hands of skill. Hands that care. The working hands of Mr. Goodwrench. No one knows your GM car better. No one.
A couple of nights ago, the five of us were sitting around talking about the future. Now, only three of us are left.
Tour of Duty, tonight at 9.
This is CBS.
Vanderstein Ford asks, what makes a great car deal?
The lowest price, definitely. But we go a few steps further at Vanderstein Ford with 20 years of award-winning service, confidential financial planning, free towing for warranty-related problems, service hours till midnight, and a sincere dedication to customer satisfaction. Right now, enjoy all this, plus these money-saving limited-time offers on our most popular models. Year after year, decade after decade, Vanderstein Ford has always offered the lowest prices on America's best-built cars and trucks.
This should give you some idea of the difference between beer and Genesee Cream Ale. Genesee Cream Ale. It's not the same old brewski.
Sports
coverage of today's Big East Tournament semifinal game is sponsored by Michelob Light. When the sun goes down, light up the night with Michelob Light. Express mail overnight service. And by the American Express card. Membership has its privileges.
Well, back at Madison Square Garden, we are sitting in on what would be a mild upset, Billy Packer. And what must Syracuse do now to climb back into this Big East semifinal game against Seton Hall?
Fred, what I think they have to do is get their basketball in their head. They came out in this game. We watched them warm up. There was no intensity whatsoever in the way that they warmed up. They have not played with intensity so far. And what we have here is Seton Hall just wants the game more than they do at this point.
Billy, let me take everybody through the storyline. Mark Bryant going out at 8:07 with three fouls. It was 19-16. Then the Seton Hall bench came alive. 8 of their 10 points were scored with Bryant out with those three fouls. At the free throw line, the Orange men would still be ahead if they could hit their free throws. They are 0 of 8. In the backcourt right now, Seton Hall hitting 40% and Syracuse only 27.
And Brent, it's been a long time since I've seen a half in which neither team has hit a three-point shot. There's been no perimeter game whatsoever on behalf of Syracuse. They've tried to pound everything inside. It'll be interesting to see whether it's Bryant or Cicely here in the second half. One's got to take over.
Douglas with only one assist in the first half of this game. Coleman coming out high. Bryant starting the second half. He's 0-0. Rowe brings it back and takes the jump shot. Seton Hall's ball.
Oh, what great block out by Ramos, but he's down. I think he hurt himself.
Now Morton off the fake. Tap back up. Ramos is still down. They'll stop play.
Great piece of officiating there, Brent. Ramos went down very hard. We'll see him extend himself here. There was some block out on his part. Now watch him extend himself. Comes right down on his chest. And the official just stayed right there with him until Syracuse got possession of the ball. You see how hard he went down. Just gave up his body completely on the play.
Certainly appeared to knock his breath away there for a moment. Now being helped up. Ramos raised in Puerto Rico, scouted by Carlissimo when he was coaching a basketball team down there during the summer leagues, one of the stronger players in the Big East Conference. And
Brent, a great student, an accounting major, really a credit to that institution both on and off the floor.
I think they were telling me he's their best student, as a matter of fact. Well, a little bit later after this semifinal game, we're going to send you out to the Midwest. Two teams headed for the field of 64, which will be revealed tomorrow, Iowa, Indiana. Douglas now bringing it to the attack, 31-24. LSU and Kentucky tied in the second half. Dale Brown, it's his time of year. Coleman on the turnaround. That time he turned back to his left.
Exactly. I haven't seen that shot in his repertoire in a long time. Kind of caught Bryant by surprise.
Bryant gets in deep. And
uh-oh, offensive push.
That is four fouls on Bryant. It could not have come at a more critical juncture of this game. They got by without him in the first half. They'll take him out here again. And they'll come with France Bolsik, number 30. They come with 6'8", trying to get some size in there.
But not the same as a man that's been averaging 28 points and 14 rebounds a game in the last five games. Well, Walker being pushed right
Ramos
back under the basket.
Ramos is out too, and now Cicely missing the turnaround. And Sally yanking away the miss, and here's Morton. Walker gets inside on Cicely, and he draws Ronnie's third foul.
You know, I didn't even look at the Syracuse bench, Brent, but after that last play and that defensive effort by Cicely, I knew Brower was coming, and out of the side of my eye, here's the man coming into the court. Ronnie has not been in this game mentally at all.
And he'll sit. The word from the Seton Hall bench, Ramos sustained a hip pointer. That's extremely painful. And
DJ is really snake bit today, not having either one of these players. It's amazing that he still retained a five-point lead.
Yeah, one of the big trees out with a hit pointer and another in foul trouble. Walker adding the free throw.
Walker made 31 straight free throws as as a freshman. So pretty proficient from that line. That's a Seton Hall record.
Well, against this Seton Hall lineup, which is smaller and not as bulky, you would think that Douglas could get inside and get something going. He draws a foul on Green.
And you'd also think that Coleman could touch the ball a little bit more in the offense right now, because he hit that turnaround jumper here to start the second half. He's a guy who could get on a roll right now. There's Coleman. They didn't get it to him quick enough.
And it was partially blocked by Bolsey. Dribbling out quickly is Green. Bolsey for the layup.
Great play.
Steal by Morton. Took it away from Rowe. Goes down and he's fouled by Douglas. Boy, you've got to admire the heart being demonstrated by these Seton Hall kids here this afternoon.
Brett, they're not only playing aggressive basketball, they're playing confident basketball.
Boeheim tries dunking again, and Rowe comes out after giving it up on that steal.
Last year in the conference, 8 of their 12 losses were by 4 points or less. So you can see how often they've had their heart broken.
Coleman comes away with it. It's 3-on-1. Douglas will go to work.
No basket.
Sherman Douglas should have dropped that ball back, Brent. Even though he's going to go to the foul line, he knew he had Coleman coming. It would have been a much easier shot.
Well, near the end of the game, Billy, you and I will select a Chevrolet player of the game, and Chevrolet will donate a $1,000 scholarship to the general scholarship fund of both schools. That was Pookie Wigginton. Watch him now. He's at the bottom of your screen, number 4. Watch Wigginton there at the line. He'll jump in front of the shooter and seal him up. Watch him get in there. Get in there on Sherman. There he goes.
Fans went crazy when Douglas hit that free throw. It's the first one they've made today. Ramos back in the ballgame. Hard-nosed kick.
So with the 3 fouls, he's out. Al Ramos will come in. Away from the ball that time. That's the first personal on Derek Brower.
One of the things, Grant, that you notice about both of these clubs, they pack their offense in inside the foul line. There are a lot of opportunities to take jump shots from the maybe even 18-foot range, but neither club looks for it. Syracuse now in the 2-3 zone on the out-of-bounds.
Wigginton only 5-4 at the point right now for Seton Hall. Handling the ball. That's the 5 on the floor for P.J. Carlissimo. They've led it all the way. Once in the first half, they were up by as many as 14. Without Bryant, they've been more patient, running to half court. Brower muscling Ramos out of the key area. They try to get it back, and there's the turnover. It's Duncan pushing it down for Syracuse. Douglas is open. Fake, penetrate, short. Goes down hard. Coleman. And as he comes up, Walker fouls him from behind, and Douglas shaken up a bit. When he went down, he crashed hard.
Yeah, he really went in there, and he's down on the floor right now. He is such a hard-nosed kid and really hit the floor hard. You watch Sherman Douglas hit the floor on this play. He comes right down awfully hard. It's a wonder he didn't really get hurt on that play.
Coleman has missed all 4 of his free throws so far this afternoon. And he ends that streak.
3 in a row, and the Syracuse rooting contingency up there really happy with it. I wish I was here yesterday to see Cycli hit 10 in a row, Brent.
They put the adventure back in free throw shooting, haven't they, this bunch? Now Walker maneuvering. Cooper. Brower tried to draw the charge. Wigginton pulls it back on the outside. Oh,
36-30.
Pookie gets right down underneath that dribble.
Plucked it out of bounds.
Did you notice that Pookie's telling the ref that Sherman Douglas is hooking him? It'd be hard to hook him, you know, he'd be putting your hand right over his head.
He reached in on the double team and gave Thompson some problems. The three misses by Douglas. And a foul on Brower.
Good blocking out on the inside by Walker.
Now we've got a timeout. Take a television break here at the 15:54 mark. 6-point lead. Seton Hall won't fold.
When the sun goes down, the light of the night, silver label, red ribbon, a taste of thrice. Gonna light up the night, gonna light up the night, gonna light up the night, gonna light up the night.
Listen to the heartbeat.
Now there's a powerful new reason to follow your heart. The new 4.3-liter V6, available in S10 Blazer. 28% more power than before, and 50% more torque. The new 4.3-liter V6, the biggest engine ever offered in Blazer's class.
The heartbeat of America.
Chevy S10 Blazer.
That's today's Chevy truck.
Ever since your post office invented express mail overnight delivery, others have tried to copy our eagle, but it's not so easy. You see, express mail overnight reliability is close to perfect, with the most convenient locations and prices as low as $10.75. About half what most others charge. So we're pretty hard to imitate. So use the original express mail service from your post office.
Seton Hall of Syracuse playing for a spot in the Big East Championship here in Madison Square Garden. Seton Hall has led it all the way, and the Stars certainly come out to watch basketball over here at the Garden. As Seton Hall brings it up, Deborah Winger and Timothy Hutton watching, and their favorite player is Pookie Wigginton. Timothy's father, incidentally, attended Syracuse, but they say really down deep, we are Wigginton fans.
California.
He doesn't dribble behind his back as much as Tyrone Boats, but he sure looks a lot like him. Does Walker and wouldn't stay down, and Ramos is muscled and fouled by Duncan.
Hey, Brent, you asked me a trivia question before, and you just brought it to my mind. You said dribble behind your back. Do you know who is the man that is so-called invented dribbling behind your back?
I gotta say, Cousy perfected.
No, that was Bob Davies, the fellow you asked about from Seton Hall.
Is that right? He was the first one you ever saw go to that dribble?
That's right.
You know who the most famous non-athlete graduate of Seton Hall is, who I know personally, is Bob Wessler, the former head of CBS Sports. Wigginton is tripped up by Sherman Douglas, and down goes Pookie.
Douglas a little upset with himself. Well, you know, when I was a kid growing up, Seton Hall had a great run. We're 28-0, one of the top teams in the country with Reagan and Walter Dukes. They eventually won the NIT that year. And, you know, they did not get invited to the NCAA, and they were 31-2 in the year.
He traveled. Cooper turned it over trying to get the handle.
So this year will be the first ever in the storied history of Seton Hall getting into the NCAA tournament. Hard to believe.
Billy, I find it amazing that they've maintained this lead with Bryant out in the first half with foul trouble, played just briefly in the second half, back out again. He's averaging better than 20 points a game, and Syracuse just can't close in completely. There's another foul on the inside as Duncan pivoted it. All right, take a look at the summary of this semifinal game right now, and you can see Bryant with only 2 points and four rebounds, and out now with four personal fouls.
Well, if you had told me that before the game, I'd be saying, on the other hand, Ronnie Cicely's having a monster game, because you'd figure he created it. But Cicely is evaporated also in this ball game.
I was talking yesterday to an NBA scout, who will stay nameless, and he told me that Bryant right there has improved his standing tremendously through the year. And he said, on the other hand, as I've watched Ronnie play here the last month, he seems to get worse in my eyes. Obviously, Ronnie will still go in the first round of the draft, but he is not impressing the scouts as you think that he might coming down the stretch of his senior year. Of course, the NCAA tournament's still ahead. Walker.
That wasn't Cycli. That was Coleman that he spun on.
Syracuse made it to the championship game of this tournament last year and lost, and then made it to the title game of the NCAA tournament. Underneath is Coleman, and he is fouled, and that foul is against Ramos. That's his second personal.
You know, the craziest thing about Syracuse, the only time they ever won this tournament was in triple overtime, and that year they didn't go to the NCAA tournament because it was before the automatic bid for the Big East.
Well, Kentucky comes back, but LSU pressured him. Tigers will be one of those teams on the fence.
And Kentucky, one of those teams, if you know, first of the year was picked number one by many. Looking like they're getting back to that shape now.
At Seekus checked into the game. What about Carlissimo's use of his bench here against Syracuse this afternoon?
I think he's done a fine job, and again, that's a matter of the confidence that this club is starting to show in the fact that they've had this good win streak, 8 of their last 10. I thought Walker has played a very good ball game coming off the bench.
Seton Hall's bench has scored 17 points, and the Syracuse bench, by comparison, only one, as the holding foul is called on Duncan. That's his third. They're shooting 1-1.
Followed by Earl Duncan. It'll be 1-1 on the foul line.
Well, Duncan did a wise thing there. He was annoyed with him with that call, was going to throw that ball up in the ceiling, and it was smart because they could not afford a technical at this point.
Hey, Haim is very frustrated. What's occurring here this afternoon?
17-1, as you pointed out, Brent. That is absolutely amazing.
Now the 1-1 becomes so important, especially to Seton Hall.
And this Seton Hall club's a very good free throw shooting team. 74%. From the line, particularly when it's well distributed.
A lot of time left for Syracuse. They had that one run in the first half.
The one thing they can't do, Brent, they can't go too far because this Seton Hall team is not a real easy club for Syracuse to press.
Douglas reaching in and Buki Wigginton fouling. Well, I guess all the mysteries will be answered tomorrow afternoon here on CBS. Jim Nance, James Brown will be over the studio. Billy, you and I will join him after the Big East title game. That's always fun to second guess the committee.
Well, some of those upsets in tournaments, as an example, let's suppose that Detroit were to beat Xavier. I don't think that's going to happen, but, you know, it really takes some of those bubble teams, puts them in very precarious position.
I can remember that everybody used to wait until Monday morning and read about it in the newspapers. Yep. And then I guess it was about 6-7 years ago we put the show on the air for the first time, and now it's become a staple.
Well, there are two teams that don't have to worry about it, Missouri and Oklahoma.
Pirates up by 6 and holding possession. There's Morton. Coleman.
Not a good pass.
Douglas back to Duncan.
Pookie Whittington. What a great play on his part.
Duncan shaken up.
Now, this is not a good pass because when you're down, you can't take the chance of making the perfect play. Whittington gets over there and underneath Duncan just in time. Probably the only guy out here that could make a play like that.
Walker spin move. Cycli. Walker reached in and fouled him.
I don't know if he fouled him or not. It was called. Pretty good job. Syracuse was off and running on that play.
You know, it's unbelievable that with this talent on the floor for Syracuse, their only field goal this half came at the 19:03 mark, and here we are at 13:31, Billy.
Well, Seton Hall's doing a good job in their man-to-man defense, and that can credit a lot of it, but Syracuse hasn't gotten anything going. No perimeter game. They haven't gotten into their offensive flow inside. Just not playing well.
Please take your seat. There's some nice people right behind you who would like to see the game. Thank you.
Thank you. Cycling hot on the free throw line, huh? said yesterday, made 10 in a row. Coleman in the lane. Jimmy Boeheim can't believe this game's a nightmare for him.
Well, this is just a lack of concentration.
Yeah, it really is. And we saw it in the shoot around when they first came out. And that ball went in by Cycles Bart. It would have narrowed the margin to four.
Brings
it up to Walker. Whenever you have a man that size that dribbles inside, you want to play him to make a pass, not the shot. And everybody collapsed on him as if he was going to shoot in there, and you know he's going to pass it out.
Knocked away. Duncan from the baseline.
Wigginton's taking it right at Syracuse.
Barking out signals. Ramos comes up on Cycli for the field goal.
I don't know what Cycli could be complaining to the official on that play. Just a very good offensive move by Ramos.
Duncan putting it down, traveled.
I think Jimmy Boeheim's got to go with a timeout here, Brent. I mean, you're getting down to the 10-minute mark. His team is not functioning at all. It just needs to slow them down and get them totally organized for an offensive effort on the half court.
Ramos backing in against Cycli. Walker, run down by Morton. Seton Hall being very patient. Ramos for two. That's his second quick field goal here, and 13 points for the game.
26-37. See, they just don't have any pattern whatsoever in their offense. They're just coming down. Doesn't seem like they have a focus at all of where they want to go with the ball.
Douglas having some trouble with focus now as Wigginton reached up and hit him in the face.
And he's going to call it inadvertent. Wigginton gives Douglas some problems being down so low.
Knocked away by Walker, but right back to Douglas, who makes a beautiful play.
And a foul by Nick Katsikas. That's his first personal foul.
Brent, although that was a good play by Sherman Douglas, it wasn't by design. It was just an errant ball that got deflected.
Jim Boeheim delivering his 10th lecture of the game to Ronnie Cycli. So we've got a timeout. Sherman Douglas's great move. Right now, the Orangemen need a little inspiration to get back in this one.
Listen to the heartbeat.
Now you can save up to $1,450 on America's best-selling cars, Chevrolets. Get $750 cash back when you buy a new Chevrolet Celebrity. And save up to an additional $700 on option packages. That adds up to $1,450 in savings. Or save up to $1,075 on a new Chevy Cavalier. Or get $750 on a new Chevy Camaro.
That's the day, Chevrolet!
Oh, it hurts. It hurts. Can you...
American Express, my daughter and I just had an accident.
Do you need a doctor?
I think she's got a broken wrist.
That was some trip. I'd like to keep this while you're away at school.
Sure.
I got something for you.
My name on it.
Just in case.
Thank you.
Someone who cares when you're far from home. Membership has its privileges.
Up here, you catch them with experience. You've got them where you want them. You head for the beer that goes down smooth as a mountain stream.
Whoosh.
How are those horses doing?
What horses?
Head for the mountains of Bush Beer.
Welcome to March Madness. Who's out? Who's in? The road to the Final Four begins with a selection show tomorrow on the home of the NCAA Championship.
Even without their star now, Seton Hall continuing to hold off Syracuse, but a lot of time left here, Billy.
There is a lot of time, but we don't see any indication whatsoever that Syracuse is ready to mount an attack, and you got to figure that Bryant can come back in the ballgame if PJ can get down in another 2 or 3 minutes.
Mark Bryant on the bench with four fouls. Ramos picking up the slack. Douglas has been the leader for Syracuse.
Morton's played a solid Ramos. Game, hasn't he? Just good decision making on his part. Oh, beautiful, beautiful. Walker hasn't played a bad game. When you start talking about some of their MVPs today, their bench play has been sensational.
Coleman double. Katsikas coming in from behind. They knock the ball out of bounds. You can see the confidence, Billy, I think, in the faces of the Seton Hall players in this game. Whereas they were scared at times yesterday against the Hoyas, and Duncan hits a three-point for Syracuse, they are definitely not frightened about this game.
Katsikas a good shooter out there, so Coleman has to go out and respect it. For Brower.
Jump hook.
Oh, made that play. A great screen inside.
Now it's three, and here come the Orange men. Crowd can feel it too.
It's a good time for PJ to think about bringing Bryant back into the game.
But Ramos keeps throwing shots. 17 points for the game.
How about Wigginton moving those feet? He just wouldn't let Sherman Douglas go by him.
Coming off arthroscopic knee surgery, and that cut down some of his lateral movement. They expected him to be very talented defensively. Douglas gets it back. A three-point chance. Wait a minute, that goes against. The basket counts, but the foul is going the other way on Douglas.
But I thought Douglas already was off the ground on this play. You see a great backdoor cut here. Well, give and go backdoor on the big overplay by Wigginton. In my estimation, he already left the ground. Should have been a foul on the defender. You see, he's not planted by the time that Sherman Douglas leaves the floor on that shot. Ball game, so PJ doesn't fall off much with his substitution there. Ramos, an excellent free throw shooter. Brent, you know, one of the things that always amazed me, big fellas that come from the foreign teams always seem to be good free throw shooters. You ever notice that? In our country, the big guys are not. I don't know why that is.
Well, take a look at the international game, Billy. They shoot very well from the perimeter. They don't play defense as well as the American basketball players, but they'll shoot with them. You were there when that Brazilian turned our lights out in Indianapolis.
They're 6'8 or 6'9 guys, always have good shooting technique from the outside and the foul line. Good screen, a good help check by Ramos.
Shot clock down to 10.
Syracuse running their offense better now than they have all day.
Brower misses the runner, but Thompson gets an offensive rebound and the field goal.
That's about the best sequence the entire day for Syracuse in a half-court offense, and end up getting a good shot.
The last 3 minutes, Ramos has been the Seton Hall offense, all 10 of their points.
Carlissimo is down now, crouched right in front of Bryant. You know his mind is turning, hoping he can get another minute or so off of these subs before he has to put him back in.
Running the clock down. Walker.
Brower out there in time. Walker has really been active on the inside.
Followed by Derek Brower.
Louisville explodes this afternoon. North Carolina against Maryland with the lead. Brower Leaves and Cycley returns here at the 8:35 mark.
James Major, number 10.
Trent Walker. Left ear is red from listening.
Walker only averaging 5.1 a game coming into this ball game today. I think that he has really been a key for Seton Hall being able to come off the bench, doing a real good job offensively, keeping a lot of pressure on Syracuse. And as I said, holds the school record of 31 straight free throws. Will Ronnie Cycley wake up on this one? It's going to be a key down a stretch.
Ramos now picking him back up as he comes to the weak side. Comes out to meet the ball.
Stevie Thompson wanting to post up Major inside.
Here's Cycley. It's a two-point game at the eight-minute mark. Carlissimo, Wayne, the big move he's going to have to make. Katsikas loses it. Ramos is right there, and it's blocked by Coleman. Run down by Walker. Gets it over and back for it. It'll go over to Syracuse on the over and back. And the Orange been with a chance now to tie it. And we'll see what they come up with right after this word from your local station.
This is CBS. Today's Duracell lasts 30% longer.
Look at us.
What?
That's another one of them Hyundai XLs.
Another one?
Another one.
More than 400,000 Americans have already bought a Hyundai Excel.
You ever work on one of them?
No. You?
No.
And some people aren't too happy about it. The dependable Excel from Hyundai. Cars that make sense.
Richard Pryor is just about the funniest man alive, says Gary Franklin, KABC-TV. See Moving, A House Full of Laughs, V.A. Musetto, New York Post. Richard Pryor, Moving, rated R, now playing at a theater near you.
CBS Sports coverage of today's Big East Tournament semifinal game is sponsored by the Heartbeat of America, today's Chevrolet. Mr. Goodwrench, no one knows your GM car better than Mr. Goodwrench, no one. And by Budweiser, proud sponsor of the 1988 U.S. Olympic team, this Bud's for you.
Well, they're setting here in Madison Square Garden for this Big East semifinal. It's been an impressive show by the Cinderella of this tournament. Seton Hall leading all the way. Yesterday, they eliminated the Hoyas. They became the only team other than Syracuse to ever beat the Hoyas in a Big East tournament game. And in the second semifinal, Pittsburgh-Villanova, and then we'll bring you the championship game tomorrow afternoon. Syracuse with a chance to tie it. We're inside of 7:45. That time, but Duncan gets it back.
But again, pretty good offensive move.
Douglas coming through. Foul before the shot. No basket.
Well, Brent, if you're Jimmy Boeheim, you can't be upset with that because now Syracuse is starting to show the half-court offense that they've been able to use so well this year. See, the big men are clearing out inside, gave a perfect lane for Douglas. The call was properly made because the foul took place way before he got inside for the shot release.
Coleman. Back to Douglas, but there was a whistle. And it'll be Coleman's turn to step up to that free throw line. Syracuse already has shot 21 free throws here this afternoon. Seton Hall has shot 12.
To give you an idea, Syracuse has shot over 300 more free throws on the year than their opponents. 300. And that's because they've been able to run their offense well and pound that ball inside.
Here's the problems the free throw line certainly has created as Coleman can tie this score.
He does. They go full court pressure. Careful if Major's going to feed the ball inside. He's a good outside shooter. Coleman can't drop in on Ramos so much.
Ramos has carried the offensive load this half. Seifele was with him, and Ramos got it up on the glass for the field goal. He's playing a splendid game, and Bryant up on his feet, knowing that with four fouls, he'll have to come down the stretch. They're going to send him in now for the last 6:30.
Good screen.
Douglas open. Had to give it up as Ramos came over. Seifele wants it. Douglas got in, and reaching in was Morton. And it'll be Bryant time for Seton Hall.
You notice that Sherman Douglas talking to Seifele right there, telling him to move. Now, he made the good play inside. Seifele should have had the dunk, but he didn't get himself properly positioned to catch the pass.
So it there gives you an indication the number of free throws missed from Syracuse, like for North Carolina when the season started. They missed 13 at the line, lost the game by only three. And you can go to last Sunday when they missed seven and lost the championship of the regular season to Pittsburgh as a result.
How many of those are front end of 1-1 also?
Going down is Douglas. He draws the offensive foul. He talked Morton into it.
Well, that's the first time today that Morton has had to face him in a 1-on-1. Nice little teamwork there as Sally just puts his arm around Morton. Sally, of course, the cousin of John Sally, an outstanding Georgia Tech player, playing so well in the pros now.
Duncan missing, but as Seifele went to reach on the inside, he committed a foul, and that's the fourth on Seifele.
Talked about Seton Hall all day long having foul trouble for Bryant. Now Seifele goes out of there. It gives a big edge the rest of the way to Seton Hall. Does it have to be Brower matching up inside with Ramos and Bryant?
If he can hit this free throw, it'll be a career high for Ramos. Thompson quickly into the hands of Douglas. Duncan on the right. Beautiful bounce pass to Duncan from the point man. Deadlocked again at 55.
They ought to go to Bryant, getting back in the ball game quickly.
Here they are. Double team. Jump pass intercepted beautifully by Douglas, who jumped in and went out of bounds. It was how Boeheim saw that hoop.
Sherman Douglas hurt his elbow on it. He has gone down on the floor today about three or four occasions very hard. He doesn't want to come out of the game. I thought he got fouled on that play before he went out of bounds.
Walker returning. Ramos will sit for a short time. Green brings it out, working with Major, Sally, Walker, and Bryant. Bryant 00. Effectively double-teaming Bryant on the strong side. Now without Ramos, it's easier for Coleman to operate defensively. Into the hands of Douglas, and he's called for traveling. I thought he was dribbling.
Now Green did a smart thing. He knew he couldn't pick off the pass, and he anticipated Douglas was going to have to catch and turn before he headed up court.
Didn't you think he already had the ball down here, Billy?
Well, let's see it. First of all, I like what Coleman did. Here you see Green cut in front. I'll tell you what, I don't believe it was a walk.
Oh, he was dribbling the ball when he came off of that.
Well, get your whistle out, Brent. You were right, but they call him.
Sally gives it up to Major.
Now, Major's got to find a hole in this zone to get himself a jump shot. Just has it. He stays over here with Coleman. Coleman's too big for him.
The defensive intensity has picked up for Syracuse here the last couple of minutes. They're playing with a little more fire in their belly.
They've never the lead in this game, have they?
They were ahead 2-0, Billy. That was the only time. Major off a fake, has to give it up. Rejected by Cycli, but into the hands of Green. Now it's Major.
Major could be a key down the stretch here. Can extend that defense out with that perimeter shooting. I think he'd be advised to go to the other side of the court, though, on Stevie Thompson's side of the zone.
Omen whips it inside to Douglas, and the foul called against Seton Hall's Green.
Douglas, he's a glutton for punishment. He's down in among the trees again.
So Green fouls out of this game at the 440 mark. Carlissimo quickly huddles up the Pirates. And next, right after this semifinal game, we'll send you out to watch Dr. Tom Davis in Iowa take on Professor Bob Knight in Indiana. The Hoosiers going back, everyone assumes, in an effort to defend that championship. And Ramos
that
suffered
hip-pointer.
That hip-pointer.
Yep. Now how about Jay Edwards the other day? He made 8 of 9 three-point plays, 35 points. They have a real scorer in the making there. Dennis Scott the other day, the great freshman from Georgia Tech, and asked him if there's anybody shoots the three better than he is. And he said, I don't want to go up against Jay Edwards. I faced him in practice one day.
That's the first front end of a 1-1 Syracuse has hit today. All right, this half, I should say. That's 1 of 3 this half. Douglas gets a tie at the 440 mark.
There's Major. He's moved over to the other side of the floor. He should be able to get off something over there.
Morton. Left-handed. Sally gets the bounce. Bryant's rebound. Coleman off with the miss. Now it's Douglas. Syracuse for the lead. They've got it on the Douglas shot in the lane.
You want him on your team, don't you? Ready ball play. Sally trying to
Sally
do too much.
Forces one. Goes to Syracuse.
PJ needs a timeout here. He's going to take it.
Debbie versus Katarina, the World Figure Skating Championships in 2 weeks.
My wild Irish road, with feet is flowing and from day for my sake she may let me take.
Paddy's Day, celebrate with the only American beer that's also brewed and bottled in Ireland, Budweiser.
Just in time. Now, get a pop-up umbrella free when you buy a brake job or tune-up at your participating Mr. Goodwrench dealer. And you can enter the America the Beautiful sweepstakes, no purchase necessary. Win a cruise to Alaska or a trip to San Francisco or Washington, D.C. or other great American cities. So see Mr. Goodwrench for a brake job or a tune-up.
Don't forget your umbrella.
And whether you buy or not, enter the sweepstakes. Mr. Goodwrench, no one knows your GM car better. No one.
The scenario with these guys grew with the mergers and acquisitions area of the law. Past litigation support of work product retrieval. Overseas, 4 or 5 different currencies. Very complicated. They're ordered as panic. They're pushing IBM. So we set the firm up with a Wang VS computer and WP Plus. Wang office in We put up a legal time billing package in a Wang 4G office and customized code. Totally integrated, totally globalized. They benchmarked us. 2 months later, they polled the jury and we won.
It's winnable then.
Definitely.
Welcome back to the Garden, everybody. Along with Billy Packer, I'm Brett Musburger. That's the game situation. Syracuse up by 2. They have trailed by as many as 14 against that man right there, the coach of the year, the Big East, P.J. Carlissimo. Both coaches with timeouts remaining in regulation. Don't think they'd get into trouble there. Douglas bringing it to the attack. Cycling and Coleman, Duncan and Thompson. Shot here won't stay down. Out of bounds. No, it was saved. Underneath the basket, Coleman reaching for it.
Brent, in this type of ball game, when you get the ball, two hands on the ball and it's in the basket like that, get it back out. You don't have to make the sensational play. Possession too important now. Three-point shot coming up here shortly for Seton Hall.
There's somebody who can do it, Major. Ramos wanted to send it back. Douglas with a great quickness and a spin move and a pass to Duncan. And a foul is on Walker. Oh, Sherman Douglas. He'll show you something new every time you watch him play.
No walking call on that one.
Almost the same, come out of here.
Almost the same type of situation. He puts the reverse on right away. Gives it off perfectly to Duncan, who can't finish because of good hustle by Seton Hall. And there's Douglas again down inside with a tough play.
18 points for Douglas, 12 of them in this half. And it's rising.
Watch this reverse. Beautiful reverse. Good dish off. Was Ramos with a great hustle to get back on defense.
Bryant going after the ball, touched it. Syracuse possession.
Very important half-court sequence here for Syracuse. They ought to just be very patient and get something down inside, Brent. One more shot to get it inside.
Douglas fires a field goal that makes it 62-57. No doubt about the MVP for Syracuse in this game.
You know, he was picked the outstanding player in his district over both Coleman and Cycli this year.
Seton Hall badly in need of a field goal this trip. Oh. Walker gets it to stay down for Carlissimo.
The big lineup that PJ has in there now with Walker and Ramos and Bryant. Biggest team he can put on the floor.
Douglas maneuvering Cycli. Now backing it up, bringing down the clock toward 10 seconds on the shot clock.
Looks like he wants a clear out for himself.
On the drive, tapped in by Cycli. They still haven't gone for the three. Bryant missing. Comes up with it again. Keeps Seton Hall alive, and the timeout is called by Carlissimo. A 3-point Syracuse lead, a minute eight. We'll be right back.
Palpatine, aggressor tank spotted.
No, no, no. In a battle drill, you need horsepower, firepower, people power. That's teamwork.
Moving tank, track front, 2,000.
This team uses a computer, thermal sight, laser rangefinder.
Ah! Yeah!
All that you can.
We win, the whole tank wins, the whole team wins. Just one person.
Find your future in the Army.
There's no place on earth that I'd rather be than out in the open where it's all plain to see. If it's gonna get done, it's up to you and to me. There's no place that I'd rather be.
Prior to owning the Chevrolet, I had a Ford. Well, I switched to the Chevy because I liked the look better than the Ford. I found out that they had completely redid the truck. You need a four-wheel drive truck. You don't want to have to get out and lock your wheels in. If you want to go into four-wheel drive, you can just shift into it. This Chevrolet truck is the best vehicle I have ever owned.
The heartbeat of America.
That's the Chevy truck.
If you don't believe it, just go out and try it yourself.
Iowa, Indiana.
A battle in the Big Ten as the Hawkeyes face off against Bobby Knight's Hoosiers. Next on the home of the NCAA championship.
For the Packer, Syracuse ball. What about Carlissimo's strategy here at this point in time?
Well, two things he has to think about. One is he's got to think about a way to get Major open for a three-point shot. I believe it's not too early to think that. The other is you got to put Syracuse on the line some. You can't let Sherman Douglas beat you with that ball handling. Here he goes again.
Douglas coming in on the inside, going coast to coast with a big miss that time. Ramos out. They lose it. Coleman's got it for Syracuse. And he was fouled by Ramos at the 57-second count. Coleman comes up to the line.
Morton did not realize that Coleman was right behind him, and he tried to push that ball up front, and Coleman intercepted it. Boeheim with that body English.
One on the line, the shooter is Derek Coleman.
He wanted the intentional foul.
He just reaching on that, though.
He greedy on that one. He got the ball back.
Well, Derek Coleman's got good rotation when he makes it.
He's made his last seven after missing three in a row there in the opening half.
Jimmy Boeheim sees a new trend, cycling 10 in a row yesterday, and Derek 7 in a row today. About eight.
They're going to need the three.
They've got Major now. Stevie Thompson realizes where he is. There he is.
Back to Ramos. Walker couldn't get it to stay down and rushed it just a little bit, and it's going to go over to Syracuse, and they can run it out here. They'll have to put him on the line. 43 seconds, the home run pass to Thompson.
Got a foul.
Not the man they want to foul is Douglas, but they do. Morton reaches in on him, and he fouls out of the game.
Don't go for this at all. Now, do we have a timeout?
He's got a fifth foul, so they're huddled over there.
But the referees have got to stop this nonsense.
This is a John Thompson timeout.
Yeah, in other words, they know they've got 30 seconds, so they just go over and huddle. Now, that's not the object here. Get a man in the game. Get him on the line, and let's shoot.
Remind everybody that the winner of this game, and now it appears as though it'll be Syracuse going back to play for the Big East Championship again against the winner of the Pittsburgh-Villanova game. Wally Massimino did a superb job last night, as he normally does down the stretch against St. John's. Douglas up at the line. Well, you got it. Don't you wonder, you know, if you're up in Syracuse and there's so many great fans up there in that city, Billy, this team's got to drive them crazy. I mean, you got one of the most talented teams in the country. You have to get so infuriated with their play sometimes, as lackadaisical as they appear, and yet they come back and they put on a show like this. And last year they went all the way to the championship.
Today they can thank this fellow right here.
You bet.
Sensational performer.
Pookie Wigginton bringing it up, but it's three time for Seton Hall. Bryant missing, and as they crashed in on the inside, Stephen Thompson picked up only his second foul of the game.
Well, when you're down six, Brent, it doesn't do any good to go ahead and force that ball down inside. You've got to take an opportunity with just 26 seconds to take a three.
Syracuse is well aware of that, of course, so they're right on Major.
Marvelous performance by Ramon Ramos of Puerto Rico here this afternoon. 21 points, 4 rebounds. He played an extremely intelligent game, too, after Bryant got into foul trouble. He really played a couple of roles down on the inside. I can see why the Puerto Rican team really wants that big fella and hopes to have him lead them all the way to Korea in the Olympics.
You know, that Puerto Rican league that he plays in the summertime, where PJ coach, one of the most competitive leagues in the world. It's run a lot of coaches out of there, including guys like Jack Ramsey that were down there, Paul Westhead, Jack McKinney. A lot of Philadelphia coaches used to go down there in the summer.
Into the hands of the quarterback, and Wigginton puts him on the line. Well, 43 seconds to go, and you know, Billy, Jim Boeheim, it's like a Harry Houdini team over there.
Well, I'm sure that he's not happy with this performance. You always want to advance in a tournament. But you talked about driving the fans crazy. How about Jim Boeheim?
Well, he was already crazy.
This is why he loves to play golf. Occasionally he can get away from these guys.
Alissimo still coaching away here with 23 seconds, and he's had a great year. He'll be going to the NCAA tournament, the Field of 64, even if they lose this one.
You know what he reminds me? I remember in grade school, they used to show you pictures of guys like DeSoto and Vasco da Gama with those beards. He reminds me of one of those guys.
Wigginton's three, and there was a foul down on the page that goes against Seton Hall, and that's number 5 against Bryant.
Sherman Douglas looked over here and just start shaking his head, smiling at me like, can you believe this thing?
Followed by Mark Bryant. That's his fifth personal foul. Five on Mark Bryant.
Been a long day for that man.
He played 19 minutes.
But down the stretch, he'd been averaging 30 points a game and 14 rebounds a game, and he really upset right now in the fact that this is not the performance he wanted.
Michael Cooper, number 31,
in
for the Pirates.
Iowa, Indiana coming your way on CBS. And, of course, we'll hear from James Brown and Jim Nance over in the studio. A lot of activity this weekend. They'll keep you right up to date on everything. Syracuse going back to that championship game in the Big East. Short.
Oh, what a pass.
This is going to do it. Syracuse the winner. They'll go to the final again, and B.J. Carlissimo, nothing to be ashamed of. He'll go to the Field of 64. He's not smiling. He won, but Jim Boeheim is not happy about it. We'll continue.
Gonna get a lesson about intimidation.
Sake, use the Gillette Good News Plus disposable. It's got the Lubra Smooth Strip, so the comfortable shave for an angel is
this little devil.
Good News Plus from Gillette.
With the design and sound of a Delco Electronics music system, now the best seat in the house is in your GM car. Delco Electronics. It's who we are.
Leave it to the good hands, people.
Suffering a loss, it means more than having a simple possession destroyed. It means suffering the shock and the aftershock that comes with a loss of control. Which is why Allstate always responds so quickly. In fact, faster than most everyone to help speed your recovery, both physical and emotional. The Allstate policy for fast, fair claims. another reason.
You're in good hands with Allstate.
All right, we're back where Syracuse has advanced again in our Chevrolet players of this game. Ramon Ramos of Seton Hall, who did a splendid job down inside, but the difference in the game was Sherman Douglas, the mighty Syracuse guard. $1,000 on behalf of Chevrolet to both schools. And Sherman, I got to tell you, it was some struggle out there. How'd you finally get things turned around for Coach Boeheim?
Well, I just think we just got some movement on offense and got Ronnie and Dirk back into the game and with my penetration. Seton Hall is a great team. They had a great year, and they senior leadership really helped them out in the first half.
Jimmy, Brent made the comment during the game. He said, I don't know how the fans can put up with the frustration. And I said, how about Jimmy Boeheim? This had to be one of your all-timers.
Hey, I had a full head of hair just 4 years ago. You know, I'll tell you, this kid on my right, Sherman Douglas, I don't say how good people are in comparison, but there's nobody tougher that I want out there in a tough game, in a tough situation. He just picked everybody right up on his back today and just carried us right along, because we weren't going to win this game. It was one of those games that we just never got any motion going in our offense. Our big guys were standing too much. And the little guy just had to say, all right, I'm going to do it. And he just took over for us. And without him taking over, Seton Hall's playing great basketball. They're on a great run. And he just took over. They're big men. You know, we get Brian out of the game, and now Walker comes in and kills us inside. But I thought Sherman was the difference. Earl Duncan gave us a real good second half, but it was mainly Sherman. Just, I think he just had the big heart today. He wanted it, and I told him at halftime, I said, we can't miss any more free throws than we're missing right now.
Now, who do you want? You want a rematch with Pitt, or do you want to take on Villanova tomorrow?
Well, right now, we're just glad to be in this situation. I think we're very fortunate.
Spoken like a true leader of this team, a real politician. Pittsburgh and Villanova coming up. Then they must contend with Sherman Douglas and Syracuse here tomorrow. So that's it. Syracuse going back to the Big East Final as they beat back a stubborn Seton Hall team, 68-63. And NCAA basketball has been a presentation of CBS Sports, home of the NCAA Championship.